2.6 billion ringgit in Najib's personal bank account. Najib so stupid, man. Put money into own account. Cannot be lah. Better sue Wall Street Journal.
Ini sebagai satu donation. Dia
really got lah.
Derma pada saya secara peribadi. Sebab itulah account itu atas nama saya. Atas nama saya.
But for what?
In the news, to fight ISIS.
But ISIS didn't exist in 2013.
This is a brotherly nation who wants to see certain parties to win in the general election. There's nothing wrong.
Like that, we must become Arab government. Where got any Arab so generous give you 2.6 billion to do anything you like one?
So how did the money really end up in the Prime Minister's bank account?
In the news,
a number of corrupt 1MDB officials treated this public trust as a personal bank account.
This is kleptocracy, and it's worse.
It all started 2 months before the 13th general election. On 12th of March 2013, Dato' Sri Najib Razak announced a mega project, the $6 billion Tun Razak Exchange. 1MDB will invest $3 billion. Abu Dhabi will match the sum. At that time, all Malaysians were so happy. Wow, Najib able to attract $3 billion from Abu Dhabi. So 1 week after, 1MDB went to the market and borrowed $3 billion. The borrowings were secured with the secret letter of support issued by none other than the Prime Minister himself. If 1MDB cannot pay, the government of Malaysia will pay for 1MDB. So 1MDB successfully borrowed $3 billion, but the money did not go into Tun Razak Exchange. Instead, it flowed into investment funds overseas. Devonshire Growth Fund, $646 million. Enterprise Emerging Market Fund, $415 million. Systemic Investment Fund, $531 million. Where are all these funds? Were they in United States? Or maybe in England? Or in Australia? Or nearer home in Hong Kong, Japan or Singapore? No! These funds were in a country that no one has ever heard of. Curacao. Yes. C-U-R-A-C-A-O. Where, did you ask? Curacao is an island north of South America. Why Curacao? Check Google. Curacao. Curacao famous for money laundering. After the money went from 1MDB into all these dodgy investment funds, on the very same day, 835 million went into Tanor Finance Corporation. Is it a bank? No. Is it owned by a big company? No. It is an empty shell company registered in the British Virgin Islands, owned by Eric Tan Kim Loong. Joe Lo's good friend! And then we found out on the same day, 681 million was transferred from Tanor Finance Corporation into Dato' Sri Najib Razak's personal bank account in a bank.
You want to know the account number?
2112022009694.
Non-Muslim can go and buy lottery lah.
So where's the Arab donor? Not only that,
ever since the US Department of Justice exposed how the money went from 1MDB into Krakow to Tanor Finance into Najib's personal bank account all within 2 days.
2 days? So the entire show about a 6 billion joint venture between 1MDB and ABBA from Abu Dhabi in order to build this Tun Razak Exchange was a complete scam. Until today, ABBA has not invested a single cent into Malaysia. Can we continue to tolerate a Prime Minister and a government that continues to cheat Malaysians like this? We cannot. We must unite to throw out the kleptocratic BN government once and for all. So, you are interested to find out more about the great grandmother of all scandals? Catch more episodes on Facebook and YouTube. Don't forget to like and share.